A 90s movie about kids banding together to find out who they truly are as they face an overwhelming future of their lives, alongside a great selection of music reflecting on the era. No, it's not The Breakfast Club, it's Empire Records. My name is Jeremy, and I host Listening to the Movies on 101.7 Silver Radio or on www.civl.ca. I play classic hits from great film soundtracks, and last night I played Empire Records. I know I said I might not come back, but I see that the site or the page has been getting a bit of attention, so I thought I might come back to do one, especially about this video, because I know I will definitely get some attention, possibly. Empire Records is about a small music store that is about to be bought out by a major music corporation because Lucas went and lost all the money purposely in Atlantic City. Little did he know that all that money was actually supposed to be used to make sure it wasn't bought out. What follows is the kids group together, have a stressful day, talk about their own lives, and never seem to work. Ever. I never heard of this movie up until a friend told me about it. I watched it, and I understood why she liked it and why the critics didn't. Empire Records is a pinnacle look at how awesome and stupid the 90s were. Small town music stores being bought out by big corporations, everyone wants to be in a band, artists have talent but don't have the drive, manager plays drum to deal with stress, there's a kid who's stupid and likes guar. Sound familiar? It should, because that's basically the stereotype 90s of characters and films. Director Alan Moyley basically based his career off doing movies about something that had to do with music and fighting the system. His highly acclaimed Pump Up the Volume would boost him up, and then Empire Records would basically bring him down. He's made a few movies here and there, but nothing as significant. Same with the cast. Many would actually go on to have successful television careers. Renee Zellweger had a decent film career, but really everyone else has gone the way of the ghost. Liv Tyler especially. The music for this film is pretty decent. It's the best feature of the film by far. The Flying Lizards, the Gin Blossoms, the Buggles, Cracker, Edwin Collins, Guar, man, I can't believe Guar was around then too, and many more. Almost all of these bands do not exist anymore because they were 90s bands. The 80s had meaningless rock bands that just rocked about women and rock. The 90s bands whined about fighting the man or inner self-reflections. Either way, the soundtrack is really good and it works well with scenes, especially during that whole shoplifter scene. While I watched this film, it brought back memories of when I was 10 years old, watching music videos on TV or the hit list on YTV, or thinking how badass you were to have a mobile disc player. And remember those horrible headphones you would get? The 90s was a time of wasted potential and permanent fog to future events like college or sustainable future. The end of the kooky technology would be an avenue for newer and brighter things like online music. What I find the most ironic about this film, though, is that the big music corporations that bought the little stores are actually the ones that are now gone, and it's the little corporations that weren't bought out that still exist. While it isn't really a good movie, I can understand why it has a cult following. I just wish it had never been cut down in the editing, or it had been a longer time period in the story itself, because it's just too short for being a single day. Deborah's sudden despair wasn't really intriguing, and Corey's speed usage was a display of hardship put on by parents want for their children to succeed. All were interesting aspects and could have been used to much greater effect. Also, how the hell does Warren keep getting out of jail? If you guys want to check out the recording of the show, click the first link in the description. If you guys want to know what I'm going to play next, click the second link for the Facebook page. I'm going to try and do this maybe a little bit more. I'm not going to be as perfect as I was because, I don't know, it was a really long time. I literally write a script, then I do the recording, then I edit the recording, then I put the recording in a video, I download the pictures, then I put the pictures into a video, and then I edit the video, and then I put the video online. So you can see how long that takes, and it's trying to do that every week, and I'm not being paid for it or anything, can be a little bit of a hardship, but I will try. Thanks for watching, guys.